All right, so 901, let's get things started. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to my my impromptu weekly webinar on all of this stuff. I'm sure you saw the news this week about record number of people that went on unemployment. You know, they're trying to put federal programs in to stunt some of this. So, you know, a lot of this is about being prepared. A lot of this is about helping people out to just at least consolidate the links. A lot of this is just to get some common messages out for, you know, people that are going to be impacted by this. So you're going to see the link in a second to get this deck. Everything that's in this deck is on my website. The link will not change. The content will. So it seems to be every other day, depending on what I'm doing. Right now, I'm trying to study for a couple of certifications, so I've been a little distracted. But as I take breaks and I see content, it gets added here. It gets organized the best that I can. So again, I'm the one working on this. So, you know, it's not as eloquent as it normally would be, but I think we need the speed of this rather than the prettiness of this. So again, you know, why am I doing this? This is just to help those people that are being impacted. So doing this, I'm releasing the deck throughout the week. You can, again, check on my page. And actually, I'll tell you what, just might as well do it since we're here, right? So let's just do this really quick. So basically, this is what the site looks like. And if you scroll down, you'll see that PDF. If you click on that PDF, it will, surprise, open up the it will open up the PDF. So again, that's how you're going to get this. So, and again, I'll change the date so that you can see where I'm back on the website here. So I'll tell you the last time I updated it on my site. So again, I'm doing this kind of in spurts. So is it possible that there's an error? Yeah, I think I'm pretty careful though. But if I do make a mistake, just let me know. I'll go correct it. The document is meant to be actionable. So in those instances where I found some early information, I'm purging it. If it becomes actionable, the deck's meant to be actionable. And again, if you have any questions, there's my email address, george@keeppace.com. Please send them to me. If you think you got a link that's interesting, send it to me. I'll make sure that I include it. Again, we just went over how to get this presentation on my website. And then occasionally I'm getting on my Facebook page. But again, right now I'm working on a certification, so I'm not getting, it's not as updated as frequently as I'd like. Kind of gave you the why, right? Again, just a lot going on. And I think it would be difficult for people to, you know, that are impacted by this to magically just start doing this work on their own. Use this as a skeleton. Use this as a guide. Obviously, your situation is going to be different than the next person. As an example, you'll see some people rent, some people own a home, some people are still working, some people are, I don't know where you are in the journey. So pick and choose those pieces that make the most sense to you. All right. One of the things I'm going to be adding to this, and this is kind of the old, you know, teach people how to fish. It's only in two sections. I'm going to show you what those sections are. But I want you to learn to use Twitter. If there's a skill that you should take out of this, it's how to use Twitter. And one of the things about Twitter is it's as close to real time as you're going to get on information. So what I've done is I put some basic instructions here about how to consume Twitter. And again, all you have to do, let me just come over here, what page that I put this on. So I'm going to give you two. If you just type in your search bar, in your address bar, search.twitter.com. Now I'm logged in. But what you're going to see is you now have the ability to search Twitter. Now, I've covered this a long time ago. Because we have some time, I want to just give you the general gist of this. You're searching people that have posted tweets, as they call them, that are up to 280 bytes in length. Those tweets are very different than doing a Google search. So you're going to learn about things called hashtags. You're going to learn about things called brevity. And when I go through the deck, you're going to find there's a difference between using a pound sign. And actually, I should make this a little bigger so everyone can see it. Okay. So there's going to be a difference between looking up something. So COVID-19 is what's called a hashtag, and it's a hashtag because it starts with that little pound. So when you then press enter, it's going to find all of those tweets where somebody included that particular hashtag. So as I go down, you can see right here, this person 21 minutes ago included point COVID-19. I'm telling you, it's a really great tool. You need to learn to speak Twitter, as I like to call it, because you're going to learn just, it's like Google, but it's different. I'll just say that. And it's another source of information I think you can use as part of this journey. We're going to come back to this where I can show you in the deck how I'm going to add these Twitter search terms. But if you don't know Twitter, it's really a good tool to learn. And again, here's the directions. A hashtag has to start with the pound. And all that is, just think of it as a tag. It's all a hashtag is. There's going to be situations or circumstances where you have to do the whole quote because a hashtag hasn't evolved yet. I think that's on the rent and the mortgage space. And again, I'll show that to you. And then there are instances where I'm going to put or, so you can search term A or term B. And then I'll have and where you have to use both terms. And that's probably as much as you need to know about Twitter. But I think it's going to be useful. Okay, where am I? Table of contents, again, this is just to give people an overview of the depth and breadth of the of what I've been assembling. Again, some new pieces that are on here will be the end on online security. That's come about over the past 3 or 4 days. There's some interesting links that I found. I don't think there was any real massive change to the table of contents with the exception of online security. So again, most of the federal state regulation stuff is out. The federal is fairly well vetted. And again, I didn't put the Twitter hashtag. When I put the Twitter hashtag, it's going to show up in the title. So rather than kind of complicate the page, it's going to those hashtags will show up in the title when I find them. You know, if you're really interested in going through the depths of it, I think a number of people, as I'll show you, have come up with really good summary information. But this is at least the federal legislation. And again, depending on what state you're in, you may need to go to your state page to keep on top of that. And again, this is the state foundation. I forget which one. Hang on, let me see which one this was on the tax. Was this... Oh, this is a good site for depending on what state you're in. So what this particular one is doing, I really like this. I found this one this week, is this site is keeping track of all of the state legislation that's being passed specific to COVID-19. So if you're looking for something that your state is doing, depending on where you're at, this really is the place to go. What else do I got here? The emotional health stuff we've talked about, yeah, this can cause a lot of anxiety. It can cause a lot of grief. Just know there are resources that are out there. I'm trying to cover them as broadly as I can. Again, all of them have advice. All of them have guidance. Each one of them, the link is there. You know, if you're feeling upset, need to talk to somebody, lots of resources for you to take advantage of. National Alliance on Mental Health. The National Suicide Prevention Hotline, webinars from, this is the National Institute for Clinical Application of Behavioral Medicine. They had a little video. At the federal and state program, they are expanding the use of either telehealth or telemental health services. So again, check your state's website to see what they may be offering. Exercise and yoga. There's a number of sites that, again, they're offering a free class or free classes just specific to you to, you know, kind of virtually network. Where am I here? Virtually network. Okay. This particular one I may take out, but this was just, again, more ideas. That's the only reason I put the LinkedIn one in. Entertainment, I did something on my YouTube channel. There's a lot of existing theatrical opera type organizations that are now taking their previous content and putting it online for free. So again, you can look around for that. These are some starting points. I think this one was new for this week. Again, this whole job search of what should you be doing if you're impacted right now or believe you're about to be. A lot of this may be common sense, but again, if you're a little upset over what's going on, it always helps to have a checklist. So most of the pages in this section are going to be reflective of what does a checklist look like. This was a neat site that I found this week, and I'm going to go to it here. This is kind of a crowd, is this it? Oh, did I lose the page? Oh, so let me make this a little bit bigger. So this is a crowdsourcing where basically what they're doing is allowing people to put in if their companies are hiring or firing. So as you go down this list on Candor, what you can see is that here's the company name in the first column. The status of what they're doing is number two, and then whatever notes that they want to include. Now, again, if I go to the bottom of this thing, where's the bottom? It's over here. I'm sorry. Hang on. I haven't played with the site all that much yet. I just want to see how many entries are in this thing. So right now there is, I didn't realize how many entries there are. So right now it looks that there's about 4,735 entries that are in this particular table. So again, it's only as accurate as the people that are putting it in, right? But at least you can look at this and get an idea if you're applying for a company, what their current status is, or if you're looking for ideas for a company that are hiring, you can come here. The bottom of this, just, I guess they have some nice graphics, which as you know about these, here's some other, links that they have. But again, this candor.co looks like a really good site, just to give you a sense as to what's going on. Let me minimize this over here, put this over here. Okay. So now, what do we got next? This was another one. It listed 9 sites. I have not been through this one yet, specific to either remote work or freelance jobs. So these are at least, this was from businessinsider.com. So between the, who's crowdsourcing the information versus these two sites, there's at least a good starting point to find out what types of jobs are out there. And again, now we're going to go through some of the articles that are going to talk about some search strategies. These are a number of people that are just giving you their insights as to what you should be thinking about. This was another one that talked about just freelancers, so I might move this one up so I just grouped those other three. New Jersey has a site specific to jobs in New Jersey that are, so there's this COVID-19.nj.gov site that you can look at. May or may not take this one out. This was an early page about who was hiring. There's probably better resources to this, so I got to check to see if I'm going to keep or get rid of this. And then understand, I've been reading a number of articles that are going to talk about the dynamics of what's going on. And is this going to change the overall theme of do we want more people working from home versus less? I think people are now getting used to a new normal, as it were. We may see more of this, we may see less. Here's some ideas for how you can potentially get prepared for that. I'm sure that's going to come up as a networking question too over time. Have you ever worked remotely? How do you make sure that you stay on target? So this might not be a bad thing to get in your craw. For those in the tri-state area, I'm assuming most everybody right now is in the New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania area, and you probably know about these, but these are for those that are new. Two excellent resources. Tom Donahue does a great job. He puts something out weekly. Basically, he culls all of the announcements from all of those groups and really gives you the list for the week. It's God bless you, Tom. It's a great thing that you do. All you have to do is if you're not on a list, like if you're part of the Breakfast Club, a mailing list, I think you get this. But if you want it to be directly added to it, there's Tom's email. Just send him an email and he adds you to the list. Alex Freund has his site called The Landing Expert. He has, it's a searchable list of groups in the tri-state area. I think it's more than tri-state, but again, it's another good resource for you to, if you're looking for a networking group, here's one place to start. If you're out of the tri-state area, you just go to meetup.com. I probably should add meetup just now that I'm thinking about it. One of the things that I've, and it's a long story that I won't get into, But what I would tell you is if you haven't interviewed in a while or you think you're going to be impacted, one of the suggestions I would have to you is start thinking about how you would prepare for your next interview. Now, yeah, there's a whole list of stuff. Is the company hiring, learning about the company, normal stuff. This is more focused on you. And one of the things, a couple segments to start thinking about. Number one, you know, for myself, because I do this and I have my studio, I'm used to looking at a camera. And to me, the camera is a person. So I'm fairly comfortable in front of a camera. I know about posture. I know about lighting. There's a number of pieces that are now natural to me. What I would say to you is start learning about a video interview, because it's highly likely that over the course of this year, you're going to see more of them rather than less of them. So I gave you one of, this is just an article that talks about video interview preparation. Again, if I get a chance, and I don't know if I have it on the next slide or not. There's a lot of sites that are out there that talk about how do you prepare, like turning off sounds in the house, getting to a quiet room, putting up a note on the door, what you should be wearing. So for example, you know, I think me wearing a blue makes me stand out a little bit better than a white shirt, as an example, or maybe darker colors are going to work for me. So there's lots of resources out there that talk about video interviewing. Highly recommend you start at least practicing or thinking about what that looks like. As an example, you may want to buy a high resolution webcam. Again, lots of study that. Another thing that I found to be one of those aha moments, as it were, this one site, which is on cleverism.com, and again, there's a number of people on YouTube as well. I have this one, I don't know how to pronounce his last name because I think that's a piece of it. But there are questions, there's a site, this Cleverism had 102 questions you should at least be comfortable answering. Obviously, they were grouped into categories, so you don't need to know all 102. At the same point in time, there's a number of sites that tell you how to use the STAR approach, which is situation, target, activities, and results. Start getting that into your psyche as to when you're asked an interview question, get your stories in place. You're going to come off that much more polished. So if you have a resume that's in play, if you have your resume done, yay, but you want to be able to know out of that resume your stories and situations that mark back to these common interview questions. I'm telling you, it's time well spent, because then when you get to the video interview, you already know what the answers are and you can be much more natural. And again, you're in this prepared of being natural in front of the camera, which I think gives you an advantage. Education reskilling, again, this is a period of time you have now, if you've been impacted, to kind of take that proverbial deep breath and figure out what you may or may not want to do next. Again, if your industry is going to be impacted for a period of time, it may be very difficult to get into that particular industry. So understand what those disruptors are. Go back earlier in the deck, I don't know if I came up to it yet, about what the economic impact is going to be. And if you're in a field that's really going to be impacted going forward, it's going to be a time to start saying to yourself, do I want to pursue another field? One of the things I love telling people to do is just a basic SWOT analysis. So if you don't know SWOT, it's strength, weakness, opportunity, and threat. Know what you're good at. Because if you start thinking about your strengths and you can match them up to opportunities, that's the sweet spot. So if you know you're really good at something and you see that there's a particular opportunity that's coming up, that really should be your sweet spot. Go after that. If you're comfortable with where you are and you haven't looked at any type of certification, I would tell you now is the time to do that. And if this is time to pursue a career change, maybe that's a time to do that as well. So before you dive into quote unquote learning something, take a moment, assess where you're at. Where do you want to be? It's usually a good idea to get that in place before you just start studying something. So one of the things that's happening is you're seeing a lot of companies offer some form of free training, either a free month, some free certifications, some initial training. I mean, yeah, you can go to YouTube and there's tons of stuff on YouTube, But these are companies that were actually making some of their content available. So, you know, take advantage of that. I found a really excellent site just on teachers and kids. So, you know, now that a lot of kids are doing teleschool, as it were, if that's the term, some resources that they can leverage. Oh, this was the economic section. So again, you know, I think it's important for you to understand, and again, everybody's situation is going to be different. Look through the economic impact. Small business, this is probably one of the ones that's come up much more recently over the past 2 weeks. A lot of the small business loans have come up. Lots of really good links here, and you can read them here, right? I've got the Small Business Association, then it's the SBA Express Bridge Loan Program, the Disaster Loan Assistance Program. Here's where you go to get those loans, some of which I believe get forgiven if you meet certain criteria. But if you have a small business, this is the list. U.S. Chamber of Commerce, again, other strategies and other guidance. So, you know, if you find that to be useful. Paying the rent. Now, rent's falling into two different categories. There's rent at a business level, and these talked about some, you know, what some of the retailers are doing. And again, I don't know what the current state of this is, but you're a small business, might be worthwhile looking at. Banks, there are certain banks now that are providing small business guidance. This was a net new one, and only because it passed my feed, it was from Wells Fargo. Again, check with your bank, because I know Bank of America and others have links. I just haven't gotten to it here yet. Specific to your individual finances, again, I don't know if I have to go through this because I haven't really done much here. I think the net new one is income taxes. I know the federal has been delayed until, I believe, July. I think they're waiting on the states. I don't know if the states have officially done that in Jersey yet, but you know, whether or not they're going to extend it past the April, whatever it is, 14th deadline, I think they're going to. But again, just check your states. Go back to the other site I had on the federal, the state legislation link. You know, if I hear about New Jersey, I'll up or New York, I'll update this, but haven't. The federal stimulus, I think we covered this one. This is just about the calculators online. This is a little bit more about the unemployment insurance, at least in New Jersey, I believe, which provided the various provisions. So that's the link, and those are the sections within the within the programs. Now we get to the interesting one, and now we get to the Twitter part of this. So there's two different camps. If you own a house, this seems to be a little bit easier in terms of how the mortgage companies are working on moratoriums and how they're working with the mortgage, people that have a mortgage. Now, what I'd like you to do is up on top where I have the Twitter hashtags, you'll notice that if you want to find out about mortgages, so let's just go back to Twitter here a second. So you'll notice I have COVID-19 and mortgage. So what I'm going to do is put mortgage up here. And what you're going to see is you'll notice there's two hashtags. There's a mortgage hashtag and a COVID hashtag. So now what you're going to start doing is getting all of that content that includes both of those hashtags, so you're immediately going to get to that particular topic. If I were just going to, if I just put in mortgage, I would get mortgage wherever it occurred, not necessarily for COVID-19. So again, if you're looking for information about the latest information, that's why I like Twitter. So again, a ton of different links here that you can go through depending on what your situation is. Now, this has been the tough one. So I've had a couple of people reach out to me if I've heard anything about where rent sits and moratoriums, and you're hearing different conversations. Okay, thank you, Ann. It's been delayed to the 15th as well. I thought I heard this on the news. I just didn't have the link to update it. So this has been the one, and yeah, Brian, you can use the "and it depends," right? Again, you experiment. Sometimes it works without it. Sometimes it helps to have "and." So this has been the one I've gotten a couple of questions on, because for as much legislation that's out there for small companies, mortgages, individual rebate checks, it seems that the rent one has not yet been addressed just yet. So the best I have found so far is a visual in terms of what states are doing. So I have these two particular links. And again, if you look up top, the hashtags that have evolved, rent zero and or rent relief. And again, let's just do those quickly so you can see them. So one is rent zero. And by the way, a hashtag, I can make up any hashtag I want. You don't have to register it. I could create a hashtag, and I'm the only one that uses that hashtag. It's a matter of what kind of the community picks up and starts using frequently. So a hashtag is just a bunch of made-up stuff. It's popular. There's a point where they become popular, and then everybody ends up using them. So again, as part of this one, here's different people. There's people coming out with petitions on rent zero. So that was one. And what did I say the other one was? Rent relief. So again, if I come back up here and I do rent relief, you'll see another one. So again, I don't know which one, because I don't rent. I don't know which one would be most applicable for you if you do rent, but those are the two hashtags that you can do a little more information and either find programs or find organizations that are trying to do something about this. So that's the best. Good morning, Robin. This is the best that that I got so far. This is old. Again, check with your utilities. Some of them are offering a moratorium on shutoffs. Student loans, we covered this. They're delaying payments and interest. This was a good one. This were companies now were starting to provide some financial guidance. One of my LinkedIn friends, Paul Zambruski, gave me the EY.com. But again, Bank of America, Citi, they're all starting to come up with just sites that are providing that overall guidance. Don't think I've touched this at all. If you need food assistance, again, check. There's organizations within each state. I think one was, check at the state level. I think another one is if you're going to go to a pantry, just make sure that it's open and make sure that it's stocked. And if you can contribute to them. I think that would be a good idea. There were actually some volunteering opportunities. I think these are all, one fell in the technology space. Another was a list of volunteer opportunities in New Jersey for my New Jersey peeps. Here those are. This was something I did, I think, the beginning of this week because I had nothing else better to do. I found all 50 states, and again, they're organized A through L, M through N, O through W. Some are much nicer and more eloquent than others, but depending on what state you're in, so if you know friends that are in different states, feel free to send this to them, because at a bare minimum, I've got their homepage for COVID. Corporate philanthropy hasn't changed. Really, it was just kind of a holding spot. And here's the section that I really wanted to cover for this week, is personal security. I think out of all of it, this is the most important section. So I want to break this into three distinct FYIs. So FYI number one, there's this concept called a two, why do I call it two fat? Because I keep getting my database mentality mixed up with my security. This is not two-phase commit. This is two-factor commit. I'm actually going to change this right here in the presentation right now, because that is just a silly error. I do this so frequently, and I still haven't reminded myself to fix that. Okay. Two-factor commit. So what's a two-factor commit? So if you go to, I don't care what site you go to, one of the first things you get challenged on is a user ID and a password. So consider that to be a quote-unquote one factor. So if I somehow steal, or let's rephrase this, if I can somehow guess what your user ID is, and then I can somehow guess or steal what your password is, I obviously get access to your site. There's really not a lot that stops me. The idea behind two-factor is that you have a second thing that is in addition to that user ID password. So as an example, your phone is another factor. So example, if I logged into a site and I have enabled this thing called two-factor, why do I have commit? George, you're just dumb sometimes. So basically what would happen is, even if you had my user ID password, it's going to ask you for a challenge, typically token. And what happens is, for example, on Gmail, when you implement, I got to change this because this is going to bother me. It's two-factor security. Aggravates me. So now what happens is when you log in, it's going to ask you to go to your other device. And usually it's a like a 6-position, 8-position number that changes every minute. So what happens is the only way you're going to get that number is on this other device or factor. So even if someone had your user ID password, they don't have your phone. So now they can try and log in all day long without this key that's changing every minute. The odds of them getting in are next to impossible. So what I would tell you is on any account that you have, now you're going to have to write this down at home somewhere, obviously. The fact that, you know, there's a security question, and we can talk about that later. But I would just tell you right now, if you can enable two-factor security on as many things as you can, that's to your benefit, number one. Number two, if don't answer the phone. I'm almost to the point of, if you don't know who it is, don't answer the phone. They will leave a message. Normally the message is going to be so stupid you're not to call back. But if someone were to call you and you really are doubting what's going on, go to that site. If it's Social Security, go to the Social Security site. If it's your bank, go to your bank and call that number. Don't trust the number that, you know, the scammer potentially gives you. And the other thing I would tell you is if you get a phone call, and you know what they do is they try to build a what the scammers do is they want to play on your emotions. So what they're going to do is they're going to create an emergency situation almost immediately. And what that does is they're trying to get an emotional response out of you, because when you get an emotional response, one of the first things you do is you turn this thing off, and all of a sudden you begin to freely give up information. So if you don't know who's calling you, don't answer the phone. That's number one. Number two, if you do answer the phone because you forgot and all of a sudden they have put you into a moment of panic, hang up, take a deep breath, because there's no immediacy. It's the phone. Maybe if the police show up at your door, that's immediate. But somebody's calling you on the phone. There is no immediacy at any point in time if a spammer or somebody that's trying to steal information from you, there is no emergency. And the only trick they really have in the book is to either pretend that they're authentic. And again, we've already talked about what you do there. You go to the website first and, you know, you ignore what they're telling you, A. And then B, if they're trying to play on your emotions, which is really the trick, right, to get you to stop thinking, hang the phone up, take a deep breath, walk away, take 5 minutes. Nothing's going to happen in 5 minutes. So when it comes to scammers, just take a deep breath. Third one, and this has been coming up, there's a program called Zoom that's doing all of the, it's allowing people to have remote meetings and webinars, and there's a vulnerability. And it's a pretty nasty vulnerability, depending on a couple situations. I don't know if Zoom has updated it quite yet or fixed it. They're going to, because otherwise they're going to end up losing a lot of business. But on the tools that you're using, this even gets down to Windows. This gets down to your browsers. Make sure that you're up to date on all of this, because as vulnerabilities are found, you want to proactively address them on your equipment rather than reactively addressing them. And of course, some of these, if there's an active vulnerability like in Zoom, you want to be able to go out, ideally on Twitter, and find out what the current state is. So again, since we're here, since we're talking, let's go over here. I have not done this yet, so I don't even know what the Zoom hashtags are. So the first thing I'll do, just as I want to find out what the hashtag is. So I'm going to do Zoom vulnerability first. So I see a couple of things here based on doing this. So the first thing is I see that Zoom, so let's go through this a little bit. So on this particular piece, that @ sign, that is the handle of an account. Mine, surprise, surprise, is @KeepPace. For Zoom, it's @Zoom_US, and that little check mark means Twitter has acknowledged that that's the site. So one of the first things that you can pull out of this is if I just wanted to look for Zoom, that's the first thing I can do. So now I at least know the account. Now let's just see real quick if there's anything specific to, I'm just looking real quick here. All right, so I don't see anything there. So now let's just click on Zoom US. All right, so that's from Zoom. Just looking here real quick. Sometimes there becomes a hashtag, sometimes there's not. Right now I'm not seeing one quickly, but at least now I know I have Zoom US. Now, I can also, if I wanted to, just so you guys know this. So now that I know it's, I can do a search on Zoom underscore US. And what I'm gonna do is if I click on latest, I'm gonna find all of the people that are tweeting about Zoom. So in the absence of having the hashtag about the event, in this particular case, you know, they're having people that are explaining what their experiences are with Zoom. Now, again, this is only as accurate as the person that's tweeting it, but it just gets back to, you want to make sure your software is up to date on both, on any of your devices, right? Your desktop, your phone, your tablets, for that very reason. Are there alternatives to Zoom? There are. I'm not going to recommend one because at the moment I don't know what they are. There's tons of them that are out there. Zoom's a unique beast. There's an open source one that a friend of mine had asked me about that I haven't had a chance to look at yet. But just stay current. Outside of that, sorry about that. George, come on, you silly boy. So that's really the, I just wanted to review the deck. That's the latest of what's going on. So again, if you're not using Twitter, I would tell you to use Twitter. I think it's really a valuable tool, number one. Number two, if you know somebody that's being impacted by all of this, send them this deck. Send them the link to my Facebook page. This video stays up, right? People that have missed this, they can watch it throughout the week. If you see a link that you think would be useful or any information that I can add to this, that would be great. And that's pretty much it. My days go, right? Sometimes I see five different links that are like, oh my God, I have to add them. And then I go for a day or two and I'm busy with a couple of other things. So that's really what I wanted to share today. Again, some really good links. I love the live crowdsource one on current state of companies. The state legislature page, I think, was good. And then the rent. I think for most of the people, again, that's been a question that's coming up. I wish I had a better answer for you. I don't at the moment. And now let me look and see. Anyone have questions? You can type them in the old comment section. Yeah, Brian, two-factor authentication. For some reason, because my programming years are in my back, I always call it two-phase commit, which is a completely different animal altogether. And I don't know why I make that mistake, but I do all the time. It's like one of those brain farts, I guess. And if you're finding it useful, you know, I'd love to hear from you. Please send me an email. Just, you know, want to know if it's helping out anybody. And I just want to think off the top of my head. I think those are the biggest ones. I think that was it. So I hope this is helpful. I hope people are enjoying this. Again, share the deck link, share the Facebook page link. If you haven't liked it. And that's pretty much it. So I'm going to do a last call here for any questions, thoughts, comments. I hope you guys are finding this useful. Otherwise, you can resume your day. It's taken about 45 minutes, about an hour. So it's about where I want it to be. So, all right. So everyone seems to be a little quiet. So I guess we can end the festivities. Stay safe, everyone. You know, please stay indoors. I know that, it can be a little scary out there right now. But, this, what's the old expression? As my mom used to say, this too shall pass. And, but we'll keep doing this for as long as we need to keep doing this to help out, as many people as possible, because I think on the back end of this, this information is going to be useful for a fair number of people. So we can end it now. Go back to your day. Have a great weekend, great week coming up, and we'll do it again next Sunday. See you soon, everyone. Bye.